Well, are you a procrastinator? Be honest with yourself, because many guys are procrastinators when it comes to preparing for a special day. Day with their girlfriend or their wife, whether it's Valentine's Day or a birthday or an anniversary, your woman's expecting a lot. Part of the problem might be expectations. But never fear, Deanna Lorraine is with us today to help us sift through all of this, making that day really special. Thanks for being with us, Deanna Lorraine.
Yes.
Now, is the problem the guy's procrastination or is the problem the chick's expectation?
Ooh, I think it's twofold.
Yeah?
I do. Women have really high expectations for Valentine's Day.
Mm-hmm.
Men often don't meet those high expectations, but a lot of men too just don't really, like, there's simple things that if men just knew, they would make the woman happy and you could just call it a day. And men just don't seem to want to submit to that.
Oh, so it's the men. We could go with that.
Yes.
You know, I do think it's funny because I think that so often, just simply knowing someone's love language right
yes.
off the top, don't
love
you think
language.
That helps? Like,
absolutely.
If she's a gifts person,
uh-huh.
then bringing her breakfast in bed is not the answer, right?
Right. Getting her, like, lots of gifts and big, beautiful displays of roses and things like that would be the answer.
Mm-hmm.
If a woman likes the words of affirmation, then the answer would be to declare your love for her. And
if you bring her chocolate
poem.
And she wants words, it's mm-hmm. just not going to work because
right.
she's going to want the words still.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So important.
Oh, yes. And the thing is, woman, you know, part of that expectation is woman, it's kind of like an unknown, men don't know this really, but it's sort of an unspoken barometer of a relationship, especially a new relationship. How much is he paying attention?
Yeah.
How much does he care about me? What are his true feelings about me?
Right.
We women sort of look to how he's going to show up on Valentine's Day to kind of determine the strength of the relationship in the early days, especially.
Yeah.
So men should really pay attention to that. That even though women won't say it or admit to it, that's kind of what's going on.
And don't you think that because men's brains are more targeted toward fixing things and solving problems,
yeah.
that they figure, if that's what she wants, she'll just tell me.
Yes.
But see, from a woman's perspective, we feel like we don't want to have to tell you. That
yes.
ruins everything. If
yes.
we have to tell you, then whatever you do.
It's not real.
Was not real because it didn't come from you. It came
yeah.
from me telling you.
I know.
So what's the answer to that, Deanna?
That's the thing, too. Women want to, like, that's the whole unspoken test kind of thing. We want to test him in a way to see, okay, how well does he really know me? So without having me tell him what I want, is he going to deliver and he's going to be sort of that perfect man that shows up perfectly?
Yeah.
And women, that's where women have to sort of release their expectations a little bit and understand that men aren't always going to show up on Valentine's Day or do the things on Valentine's Day that are going to be perfect for
mm-hmm.
them.
Mm-hmm.
But women should let them know a little bit, hey, I like to be surprised. Or, you know, drop little hints here and there as to how they like to be surprised or romanced.
Mm-hmm.
And men should know, too, that a woman, like, the whole point of Valentine's Day, really, is women like to feel special. They like to feel romanced, and they want to feel that the relationship is valued by the man. So how does a man go about doing that? One thing that's important is for a man to ask her in advance, like, officially, formally, would you be my Valentine or will you spend Valentine's Day with me?
Mm.
Weeks in advance. And a guy shouldn't just assume just because he's seeing a girl or just because even with a girl or because he's married to her that she's going to feel like she's his Valentine.
Yes.
You know, and it goes back to sort of grade school. Women like to be pursued.
Yeah.
And ask her formally, will you be my Valentine in
right.
next month?
So
she feels
so
more special.
If for things like Valentine's Day and there are anniversaries and things like that, does it matter to men how this is handled? Because I never hear men complain about this. And then I always come up to these holidays and I think, now wait, am I supposed to get him something too?
Mm.
Am I supposed to? So what's the reciprocity there?
I believe that in Valentine's Day, it does seem to be, it's more about honoring the woman
mm-hmm.
and valuing the woman in the relationship. But women should definitely show some affection and some value too as well. And they can get guys some, like a single red rose, or they can do the lingerie at the end of the night. They could give him like a coupon book of love, you know, where they're redeeming certain things, certain coupons for things like a massage or home cooked dinner,
mm-hmm.
you know, certain things. But I think the majority of the gifts or the efforts should be on the man's part.
So for the guy who
but
waits
yes,
until the day before the anniversary
yes.
or the day before the birthday or the mm-hmm. day before Valentine's Day,
yes.
now what? Or day of, which is
yeah,
probably even
that's
more
tough.
Yeah.
So yeah, normally you would want to book in advance things like restaurants or activities or hotels. Mm-hmm. Now, if you really procrastinate and you didn't do that, call every place, but there might not be a place available to have dinner. So do a home-cooked date at home where you cook your girl dinner.
Okay.
And, you know, make it really fancy-smancy. Have her dress up as if you guys were going out. Do candles. Do
have someone,
you know,
take the children if there are children.
Meal. Absolutely.
You need to be alone.
Get a babysitter.
Yeah.
It's worth it. Find a babysitter. I don't care where you find one. But it's worth it because you do need that intimate, romantic alone time. Mm-hmm. And make it formal if you're going to be cooking dinner at home. Make it as formal as possible.
Now, I'm sorry. You're going to have to define that for some guys. I don't mean that they're rubes. It's just not where their brain goes.
True.
So, I mean, you can make something formal by even just some candlelight.
Dressing up. And have
some
candles.
Dressing up. It doesn't mean that
having
you have to
rose petals on the
crystal.
Table.
Exactly. It doesn't mean, I mean, you could do even a cute formal barbecue, right?
Yes, that's
with
cute.
The girl. And you can make it to where it's
have
cute.
An apron, kiss the chef.
Exactly. There are ways to make this really...
Have defined courses, too, like an appetizer, and then you have dessert afterwards, and you have, like, these courses throughout the meal, which make it a little bit more formal.
Mm-hmm.
Champagne and an ice champagne bucket. So things like that, right?
And for some reason, fondue is always formal.
Ooh, fondue is formal
Even
and
when
it's sexy.
Casual, fondue is formal
it
and
is.
Sexy because you can feed each other.
Yes, and it's a great last-minute thing.
I think so, too.
Cooking lobsters, things like that, you know, scallops, shrimp scampi. Also, if you go to Groupon, you can, you know, Groupon has some great last minute things.
That might be a great idea.
Yeah.
Going to those kind of places. Because they're out there trying to market to exactly that client who completely forgot whatever the holiday is.
Now, I don't believe in gift certificates, though. Gift certificates
oh
are
my gosh, no.
No.
Oh my
no,
gosh,
no. No, A lot of guys think, oh, hey, let me give her a gift certificate for a massage. Heck no. It screams last minute all over it and no thought.
Exactly. However, booking a couple's massage, not a bad idea.
Yes, or an activity date like skydiving or flying trapeze or whale watching or something like that. That's an activity date for the two of you. Or you can do it throughout the whole weekend.
Mm-hmm.
Say, look, honey, you know, we have a whole Valentine's weekend, not just one night. So in case you booked up things were all booked up tonight, you have the whole weekend to kind of draw things out.
But be careful on that one, because I can see guys booking what they like to do rather than booking what she likes to do.
Yeah.
I think if guys just think, what is the number one thing she really loves?
Right.
Do that. Whatever that is, do that.
Yes.
Because chances are,
suck it up.
It's one of those things, especially I think in long-term relationships, mm-hmm. that there's pull on, you know, that this is what she loves to do, and this is what maybe he doesn't love to do. Mm-hmm. Whatever it is that she loves to do that day, it's what she likes.
Yes.
Yeah.
And don't forget the card, men. Just like what you're saying before, women love to have the card. And
the
writing.
Words in the card are so
the words.
Yeah, it's not. Don't, and what the card wrote on the card is not the words.
No,
from
don't
you.
Write love, John, after the whole Hallmark poetic.
Now my husband's going to be sure I'm talking about him because his name's John.
Uh-oh.
Poor guy.
Sorry.
No, but I appreciate that. And so, you're right.
You
have to write the card in your own words. Even if the card has the best words ever and they nailed it, that card company.
Write at least a paragraph. Something mushy.
Exactly.
The mushier, the better, and the more lavish, ridiculous display of roses, stuffed animals, or chocolates, I think the better, too. I think even though it might be embarrassing for the woman to have that arrive at her work or something, I just think it makes the girl feel special.
And you make
like
a great point, too, that arriving at work or arriving out of the normal setting instead of just at home is kind of a cool thing, too. All right, Tia and Lorraine, you rock. Thanks so much for being on Smart Life with us today.